Hello guys, so for today's discussion, we will be answering some sample problems in weight-volume relationship, mass-volume relationship, and relative density. So let's get started. So for example 3.2, we are given the moist soil sample, wherein given po yung total volume, total mass, moisture content, and specific gravity of soil solids or GS. So we are looking for the moist density, for the dry density, for the void ratio, porosity, degree of saturation, then volume of water in the soil sample. So let's answer number or letter A. So to find the moist density, we know that density is simply mass over volume, and we will use the total mass, which is 2350, kasi included dyan yung pati mass ng water, right? But the mass of air is negligible. So, kumbaga, ito ay mass ng water plus mass ng soil solids all over the total volume, which is 1.2 cubic meters. So, you'll get 1,958.3 kilograms per cubic meter. So, yun yung sagot mo for number 1 or letter A. Next is for letter B. Let's look for the dry density. So, again, guys, when you are looking for the dry density, you simply disregard the water. So, tatanggalin mo lang yung mass ng water, kaya matitira is mass ng soil solid lang over the total volume, right? So, you can simply write the mass ng soil solid all over the volume. Okay, now, as you can see here, yung mass na to is yung 2350. Bakit ginamit niya yung 2350? Whereas, 'di ba, sabi natin dapat ang gagamitin is yung mass ng soil solids lang. But because ginamitan siya ng ano na sa baba, 1 plus omega times volume, 'di ba? Wherein parang ang nangyari diyan, binawas mo. Nagigets niya, parang pag dinidivide mo kasi yung isang bagay ng factor, may nare-remove sa ibabaw. Okay, may na, kumbaga may na eliminate sa taas. Okay, so by dividing it by 1 plus the water content times the volume, parang na-remove mo yung water. Na-remove mo yung water kasi guys, ganito eh. Hindi naman given yung ano eh, 'di ba? In the first place, hindi given sa atin yung mass ng soil solid. Wala eh. Wala kang pakahanapan. So, didiskartehan mo. Ang gagawin mo, instead na mass ng soil solid yung gagamitin mo sa numerator, i-consider mo pati yung mass ng water. Parang isasama mo yung mass ng water and then i-divide mo na lang siya. Nagets nyo ba? I-divide mo na lang siya doon para matanggal yung water. So, giving us the dry unit weight, which is 1,803.3 kilograms per cubic meter. Okay, but later on, I will show you another solution, no? So, kung medyo malabo sa part na to, baka yung solution 2, medyo madali sa atin, no? Then for part C, so we are looking for the void ratio. And we know that to solve for the void ratio, no, may formula tayo sa gamma dry. Tama? If you can remember, gamma dry is equal to GS raw water 1 plus E. So, may na-compute or na-compute mo yung raw dry. Tama? And then, may GS ka na given. Raw ng water is simply 1,000 kilogram per cubic meter lang naman yon. And then, you can solve for the void ratio. So, let's try to to manipulate the equation. So, kung isi-simplify mo yan, what will happen is that it will become rho d. So you can simplify this by cross multiply mo, tama? Okay, and then ayan, magiging GS raw water over rho dry minus 1. Tama? So ito na, ito siya, no? And then you substitute everything. You have the specific gravity of the soil solid, 2.71. You have the density of water, which is 1,000 kilogram per cubic meter. You have your raw dry, which is 1,803.3. Then minus 1, so you'll get 0.503. That is your dry or void ratio. And we know na another formula for void ratio is that it is equal to, diba, volume, voids over volume of the soil solid. But then, wala tayong ganyan. So, dun ka lang magre-rely sa mga given value. Again, your formula will depend on the given values. Kahit nasabihin mong may formula na ganyan or meron pa yung isa, no, yung in terms of porosity. But then, we cannot use that formula since hindi naman given yung porosity. But, tinatanong siya. Tama ba? Tinatanong siya for our next question, no? So, we are looking for the porosity. So, to solve for the porosity, we know that porosity is E over 1 plus E. And, sabi ko nga, kung hindi mo kabisado yan, it's okay kasi baka ito yung kabisado mo. Tama? Pareho lang naman. So, let's see. So, yan yung gagamitin mo. Na-compute mo tong void ratio. Then, 1 plus E, you'll get 0.335. What if ito gamitin ko, no? Kumbaga, ship solve ka na lang. So, we have 0.503 is equal to N over 1 minus N. So, what will be your answer? So, N is also 0.335. Okay, guys. So, that's your letter D. And then, for letter E, we are looking for the degree of saturation. And we know that we can use the formula sewages. Okay, so ito lang din yun. Kumbaga, dinivide lang yung left side. So, to solve for the degree of saturation, we have omega, which is naka-percent siya. So, divide mo sa 100, no? Times yung GS. Okay, omega GS all over the void ratio. So, you'll get 0.463 or 46.3%. And then for the last item, so we have, or we are looking for the volume of water in the soil sample. So basically, we are looking for, right, volume of the water. So we know, right, diba, that density is equal to mass over volume. Tama? Now, to solve for the volume, we can divide the mass by rho. And if you are looking for the volume of water, you can use mass of water all over density of water. So, dun to galing. Okay? And then, we know that the total mass is mass ng water plus mass ng soil solid. Walang mass ng air kasi negligible, no? So, to solve for the mass of water, that is equal to M minus mass of the soil solid. So, dun galing to. And then, rho ng water. Madali lang naman yung rho ng water. 1,000 na yan. And then, ganito siya guys, ha? Diba, okay. So, diba ito yung mass ng soil solid mo? Ito siya. Pa lang. Ito yung M. Okay? Tapos, wala tayong mass ng soil solid. Again, tama ba? Hindi siya given eh. Ang given sa atin is yung total, is yung mass ng soil particle. Tama ba? Uy, yung total mass yung given sa atin, which is yung point, yung 2,350 kilograms. So, yun yung i-utilize natin. So, how do we compute for, or tandaan nyo kanina, paano natin ni-remove yung ano? Kung naalala nyo, paano natin ni-remove, 'di ba meron tayong mass ng total mass? 'Di ba ni-remove mo siya or tinanggal mo yung water sa kanya by dividing 1 plus omega times volume. Tama ba? Sige, balikan natin. Ito siya. Tama, ito 'yun, no? Okay, so same thing with this one. Para matanggal natin yung sana tayo. Okay, same thing with this one. Para matanggal natin, no, yung ano sa kanya, yung, tawag dito, yung water sa kanya, i-divide mo lang siya ng 1 plus omega. Ganun lagi. Pag gusto mong tanggalin yung water sa total mass, i-divide mo lang siya lagi ng 1 plus omega. Okay lang doon. Eh ma'am, bakit 1 plus omega times volume yung kanina? Ito. Ba't may volume? Ito, totoo. Kasi guys, parang nangyari dito, may volume naman na talaga siya sa ilalim, di ba? So parang, yung ms here is pinalitan siya ng m over 1 plus omega. So again, pag gusto mong tanggalin, no, parang makuha mo lang yung dry or yung soil solid lang, yung total mass, i-divide mo lang ng 1 plus omega. Tatanggalin mo lang yung water. Ganun lagi, ha? Okay, so I hope nakakuha kayo na idea doon. Kasi hindi laging given ang mass ng soil solid, eh. Usually, ang binibigay is yung total mass. Ayun, so that you simply substitute all the values. Mass is 2350, 1 plus omega, all over the raw ng water. You'll get 0.186 cubic meter. Okay? Okay, so now I'll show you the second solution. I hope ma-appreciate niyo yung second solution. So, ito, yun pa din. Okay? Yung sa part A, yun pa rin siya. Wala namang ibang solution dyan, eh, kundi yung mass over volume lang. And that's quite easy. But, in the case of your part B, parang ganun pa din siya, no? Wala namang pinagkaiba. Diba, yun pa din siya? Same na same, no? San lang na bago? I think, dun lang na bago sa part ng C, sa part ng D, part ng E, saka part ng F. Now, dun lang may changes. So, let's discuss it, no? For number or letter C, ano ba yung question sa letter C? We are looking for the void ratio, right? So, for C, we're looking for void ratio. So, here, ang ginawa, ganito, no? Kumbaga, we know that, we know that the void ratio, ito, tandaan niyo pa ba yung last time na discussion natin? Na ang, volume of soil solid is equal to, volume of soil solid is equal to, teka, balik tayo sa rho. We know that rho is equal to mass over volume. So, if you're looking for the volume, that is mass over rho. So, kung gusto mong kunin, guys, no, yung volume ng soil solid, kailangan i-multiply mo, ito, gagawin mong raw water times specific gravity of soil solid. Ganun lang siya, guys, kasi we know na ang concept ng density is nanggaling sa specific gravity. I don't know kung na-discuss ko to. Take note, the specific gravity is density ng any object all over density ng water. So, if after ka sa ano, no, sa mass ng soil solid, kasi volume ng soil solid to, so mass ng soil solid 'yon, no. Dapat ang gamitin mo is raw water times GS, kasi 'yun nga yung pagkuha ng any density. So any density ng any particle density is imumultiply mo lang yung specific gravity times the density of the water. So kung gusto mong kunin yung density ng soil solid, tama, then imumultiply mo yung specific gravity ng soil solid times density of water. Kaya dun siya galing. Kaya naging ms over gs raw water siya. I don't know kung mas malinaw sa inyo yung part 1 or yung solution 1 than solution 2, but ganun siya, guys. I hope na gets nyo. Okay, I hope na gets nyo, kasi quite ano lang naman siya, imamanipulate mo lang. Again, ulitin ko, magagaling siya sa concept that density is equal to mass over volume. So, kung gusto mong kunin yung volume, magiging mass over rho. Right? At kung gusto mong kunin yung volume ng soil solid, okay, dapat ito mass ng soil solid, at ito dapat density ng soil solid. But then, take note that specific gravity is equal to density of any object over density ng water. Okay? Now, if you want to get the density or specific gravity of the soil solid, dapat density ng soil solid to. Therefore, lalabas dito, lalabas dito, dito manggagaling ha, that density of the soil solid is Gs rho water. Kaya ito, pwede mo nalang palitan ng Gs rho water. Kaya ito yung kakalabasan niya. So, dun galing yung equation na to. I hope nasundan niyo siya, guys. Okay, so ito siya. Ayan. Then, substitute mo yung mass ng soil solid. Ano yung mass ng soil solid, guys? May mass ba tayo ng soil solid? San siya nakuha, okay? Ayan. Kinuha siya from part B. So, we know, di ba, para matanggal mo yung water sa total mass, i-divide mo lang siya ng 1 plus omega. Kaya matitira lang is mass ng soil, solid. Okay, so dun siya galing. And then, Gs is given, then rho ng water. Ito ay volume ng soil solid. But, we are looking for the void ratio. Di ba, we know that void ratio is volume of voids over volume of soil solids. Tama? Tama, no? But then, okay na tayo sa volume of soil solid. Ito na siya. So, ang goal na lang natin is si volume voids. But we know that total volume is volume voids plus volume ng soil solid. Right? Tama ba? Okay. So, para makompute natin yung volume voids, edi V minus Vs lang. May V ka ba? May total volume ka ba? Yes. Ang total volume mo ay 1.2. Tama? Tapos meron kang volume ng soil solid, kakakompute mo lang. Therefore, makukompute mo na yung volume ng voids, which is 0.402 cubic meter. Gagamitin mo yung alam mong formula, no? That is 0.402, volume voids over volume soil solid. So, 0.402, nakompute mo yan kanina, over the volume of the soil solid, 0.798. So, you'll get 0.503. Pero, I think naiisip nyo na mas maganda yung solution 1, di ba? Parang mas direct than ito, ang dami bang kukunin. Okay. Next. So, part B, no? Dahil may volume voids, volume soil solid ka na, pwede kang magbalik dun sa pinakaunang formula ng porosity, which is volume voids over total volume. And you have the volume voids, 0.402 over the total volume. That's why you'll get the same answer kanina, no? And for part E, you can solve for the saturation degree. Because we know that the degree of saturation is simply, ano yung degree of saturation? Volume water over volume voids. Diba? Na-discuss natin to last time. Yes. Kaya lang, may volume voids ka nga. Kaya lang, wala kang volume water. But, don't worry, kasi we know that volume voids is composed of volume water plus, volume water plus volume ng air. Kaya lang, wala tayong volume air. So, hindi siya pwede. So, cancel na yan, di yan pwede. Ano yung isa pang maiisip? Okay, sige nga, tandaan nyo. We know, ito yung kailangan natin, no, yung volume water. Alam naman natin na ang density is equal to mass over volume. So, if you are looking for volume water, ang gagawin mo lang, if you are looking for volume na magiging mass over rho, so para maging volume water ito, dapat mass water, density water. So, dun galing to. And may mass ka ng water. Uy, tama ba? May mass ka ng water. Ano yung mass ng water mo? 186.1. San siya nakuha? San nakuha yung mass ng water? Eto. Okay? Sa, ayan. Ito. Okay, dyan na siya kinuha. Parang hindi niya pinakita kung paano na-compute, no? Andito na lang siya bigla. Okay. Ayun na lang bigla yung mass ng water, 186.1. So, if you want, na ipakita ko siya. Okay, mass water is equal to mass ng, pakita ko siya sa inyo, mass. Sige, i-ano muna natin. Simulan natin sa total mass. Total mass is mass water plus mass ng soil solid, right? So, to solve for the mass of water, that is mass minus mass of soil solid. So, mass water. So, tama ba? Given yung mass natin. Then, para makuha may mass ng soil solid, uy, kukunin mo lang yung, i-divide mo lang yung original mass sa 1 plus omega. So, sige, tingnan natin kung ano sagot. Mass water is equal to the mass. Ano yung mass total? Ano yung mass total? Ano, mabubura na naman siya. 2,350 nga ba? 2,350 na. 2,350 minus 2,350 over 1 plus 8.6 over 100. So, let's see what is the mass of water here. So, ayan. 2,350 minus 2,350 all over 1 plus 0.6 over 100. So, you'll get 186.09. So, dun siya galing, guys. Pasensya na. Masyadong yung ating nasa PDF is naka, ano na, automatic na. So, dun galing, guys, yun. Uy, okay lang. Dito siya, then transpose, then apply the concept. When you are looking for the soil solid only, the total mass will be divided by 1 plus omega. Laging ganon. Okay? That's why 186.0958 or 186.1 divided by the density of water, so you'll get 0.186 cubic meter. Exactly the same nung sagot kanina using solution 1. And then, for part F, oh, yun na. For part F, we can solve for, ano ba yung part, ano? Part F. Teka, hindi ko kabisado eh. Part F is, part E, degree of saturation. So, to solve for the degree of saturation, that is volume water over volume voids. So, ano yung volume water mo? 0.186, ayun na yun. And then, volume voids mo, 0.402. Na-compute na yan kanina. So, you'll get 46.3. Then lastly, to solve for the volume of water in the soil particle, na-compute na siya kanina, ito siya. Tama. So that's it. That's how we solve. That's how you use two solutions to find the following items, no? So ano mas bet nyo? I think mas gusto nyo yung solution 1. Kasi mas direct to the point. Wala na siyang paligoy-ligoy. Okay. So, ito guys, hindi ko na to, itong problem na to is quite, ano ba? Ano ba masasabi ko sa problem na to? This is somehow formula-based, masyadong formula-based, no? Ayan, masyado siyang formula-based, but, okay naman. Sige, try natin siyang sagutan ng ibang way. Ayoko tong way niya na to kasi masyado mahaba. So, ang tinatanong lang dito is determine the mass of water to be added to 10 cubic meter of soil for full saturation. Ang ginawa sa problem na to, pinakita na lang to bigla. Hindi sinabi kung saan siya na-derive. Let's try to derive. We know that density is simply mass over volume. Right? And if you can remember, from our discussion last time, diba, we know that mass is equal to, sige, balikan natin yung equivalent ng mass total. We know that mass total is mass ng water plus mass ng soil solid. Right? So, and we know that mass water is omega GS rho water, kung tandaan nyo to, plus mass ng soil solid is GS rho water. And we can factor out GS rho water, matitira yung omega plus 1. So, dun to galing. GS raw water, omega plus 1. Papalitan ko na. So, density is equal to mass. Again, mass is, ito. Ito yan, diba? GS raw water, 1 plus omega. Okay. So, for the volume, guys, tama ba? If you can remember last time, volume is equal to 1 plus E. Naalala niyo to? Yes, no? 1 plus E. Now, if we will try to, ano, to simplify this one, since we know that E is equal to N over 1 minus N, we can replace E here. So, we have 1 plus, yung E natin is N over 1 minus N. Tama? And then, we will simply add these two. So, we have here 1 minus N plus N, giving us, ano na lang to, cancel na to, no? It will become 1 over 1 minus N. Therefore, this one here, yung V, is equal to 1 plus E, right? And 1 plus E, 1 plus E, pag sinimplify, becomes 1 over 1 minus N. So, palitan natin. Clear na sa atin, no? 1 over 1 minus N na tong V na to. 1 over 1 minus N. Simplify. It will become GS rho water 1 plus omega then 1 minus N. Dun siya galing. I hope na gets nyo, nasundan ninyo. Ayan. So, naging ganito. Paano? Ano ba property ng saturated? Degree of saturation is equal to 1. Right? And we know that we have the formula C wedges. So, if this is equal to 1, therefore, this becomes yan na. Tama ba? And we know porosity. Now, porosity is equal to E over 1 plus E. Tama, no? 1 plus E. Right? So, we can substitute here yung omega GS. Then, 1 plus omega GS. And from here, we can solve for omega by cross-multiply. So, this becomes N 1 plus omega GS is equal to omega GS. We will distribute this. This becomes N. N omega GS is equal to omega GS. And then we will transpose. This becomes omega GS minus N omega GS. Then we can factor out here si omega. Right? We can factor out omega giving us GS minus N GS. Therefore, the value of omega here will be N all over GS minus N GS. Or that is simply GS 1 minus N, right? Minus N. So, again ha, nasundan nyo naman from this concept, we learned that omega is simply N over GS 1 minus N. Okay, and then from here, we will simply substitute the value. That becomes density is equal to GS. Doon siya galing, guys. And actually, saturated na siya. Saturated na to kasi, ba't na siya saturated? Kasi, ginawa mo na ito, nanggaling siya sa concept that the saturation degree is equal to 1. Kaya saturated na dapat to. Masendan nyo ba? That's it. And now, let us substitute all the values. So, yun na. Puro substitution na lang to, guys. No? So, thus, we can solve for the, ito yung density ng soil mismo. Tapos, ito yung saturated. Pagka fully saturated siya. So, let's solve, no? For the density of the soil, ito lang siya. So, isubstitute mo lang lahat ng values na nandito. Okay? So, makukuha mo is 1,800.96. Tama? And then, for the density saturated, sundan mo lang to. So, 1 minus the porosity, GS plus 0.4 times the density of water, which is 1,000. So, you'll get 2,008. And then, ang gagawin mo lang, para makuha mo yung density lang mismo ng water, kasi ang gusto mong makuha is yung mass ng water eh. So, using density is equal to mass over volume, we know that mass is density times volume. So, kung gusto mong kunin yung mass ng water, density ng water times volume ng water lang siya. So, kukunin mo yung density ng water. So, paano kukunin yung density ng water? Isasubtract mo lang yung saturated dun sa mismong soil particle. Makukuha mo yung water. Tama ba? Yung ia-add na water. Again, ia-add na water. Iba siya sa water content ng soil mismo, ha? Dadagdagan pa ng water yung mismong soil particle. Okay? Kaya, nung na-compute yung difference ng saturated and yung density mismo ng soil, nakuha mo 207.04 at minultiply lang yung density ng water na yan by the volume of the water na i-add, which is 10 cubic meter, kaya mass of water is 2070.4. Okay, so dun siya galing. Okay guys, so let's have this example for our relative density. So we know the formula for relative density, right? That relative density is equal to Emax minus E over Emax minus E minimum times 100%. Or if ever na ang given is gamma dry minimum, gamma dry maximum, take note that Emax is the reciprocal, or simply 1 over gamma dry minimum, while E min is just 1 over gamma dry maximum. So, kung ang given is gamma dry minimum and gamma dry maximum, ito yung pag-compute ng Emax and E-minimum, and you'll still use this formula. Okay? So, for this problem, no, given sa atin yung Emax, which is 0.75, E-min 0.4, GS 2.68. In the field, so the soil is compacted to a moist density, which is, ano lang siya, gamma, no? Ay, sorry. Moist density, pero nakakilonewton. So, ano yan? Gamma nga, no? Hindi siya, density lang yung term, pero yung unit niya pang unit weight, eh. So, gamma yan. At the moisture content of 12%, determine the relative density of compaction. Okay, so for this problem, hindi ko nagagayahin to, guys. So, we have the relative density is Emax minus E, Emax minus E minimum times 100%. So, okay naman tayo dito, given yan. All we need to do is to solve for is, and we know that gamma saturated or gamma is simply, ano yung formula ng gamma? GS plus, ano yan? GS plus SE, tama ba? Or GS plus omega GS. Tama ba? Times gamma water over 1 plus E. Ayan. And we know, so from here, pwedeng i-ano eh, actually, pwedeng i-factor out, no? Magiging gamma is equal to, pwede i-factor out yung GS, so magiging 1 plus, or GS, 1 plus omega, over 1 plus E times gamma water. Tama? And lahat naman yan nasa ano natin eh. Lahat naman yan is nandun sa ating given. So, to solve for E, lumalabas na equal lang siya kay, teka, simplify natin. E over gamma. So, si E is simply, ayan, GS 1 plus omega, okay, over, times gamma water over, gamma minus 1. Okay, so let's substitute everything. So, GS is 2.68. Moisture content is 12%, 0.12. Then, gamma water is 9.81, right? All over the moist density, which is 17.63. So, what is the void ratio here? So, we have 2.68, 1 plus 0.12. Actually, kahit di mo siya i-simplify, guys, no? Pwede mo na i-ship solve dito, di ba? Nagmagaling lang tayo. Nagbida-bida lang tayo, pero tumagal lang, di ba? May ship solve naman yung calcu mo. So, you'll get 1 point. Sorry, may minus 1 pa pala dito. Minus 1. So, you'll get 0.67, right? 702. So, yun siya. And then, you'll go directly to the formula. So, again, nakuha mo 0.67, no? And then, using the formula, ayan na yun. Hindi ko nasusulat ulit. That the relative density is E max minus E over E max minus E minimum. Then, times 100% mo na lang. So, you'll get 22.9%. Okay? So, that's it. That's my discussion for today. So, I hope na-gets nyo siya. And thank you. See you soon sa ating next discussion on Atterberg's limit. Atterberg limits and soil classification. So bye. Thank you for watching.